So let me tell you a little bit about the lights that I put on my V11. Let's go. So today, I'm gonna take a little trip to the store. I need to get some glue and some Velcro. You know how that is. Creativity at its finest. Several people have asked for a video talking about how I put lights on my V11. So today, I think I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna show you which lights I used. Of course, they'll be in the description box down below, so you can hit the link and go directly to it. And I'll give you an idea of how I put it together and made the lights that the V11, I think, should have come with. But of course, that's just my opinion. And I think that opinion is shared by many, because that's the one of the things that I think it's missing. I think the V11 is an amazing wheel, but I like lights. I like being seen at night, and I think there are many others who agree, and that's one of the few things we don't get on this fantastic wheel. So, I just added them. Why not, right? You know, we do a lot of DIY on our wheels. As you can see, I have a seat on mine that is definitely DIY. And I'm loving it, loving it. All right, let's go. Wow. Electric unicycle. That lady went through that stop sign without even a hesitation. Like the stop sign wasn't even there. All right. I don't think they really want me filming in here, so. So as you can look around the wheel, you see that not only did I put the lights on, but I also put tape on it to reinforce it for a little while the glue that I put on, or the double-sided tape actually, was to dry. In the back, you see I gathered all the wires, and I put all the wires together, and then I put those wires balled up together and bunched them up in the back so that I didn't have to worry about them sticking out. I wanted to have it all one spot, concise, and if you look at the way I have it, it doesn't look great right now. I just kind of taped it together as a test, I guess, to see how I can get it to look, or how I can get it to work rather first. Now I'm gonna show you exactly what I did to put LED light strips on my V11. It's not the prettiest job. I did it really quickly because I knew the group ride was coming up and the idea was that they were gonna ride at night. I knew I wasn't gonna stay the whole night, but I knew I was gonna ride some at night. So I put it on here hurriedly and I did not go back yet and make it look pretty. So I'm sorry for the crudeness, because that's not how I like to finish up things. I like to give it a nice look if I can. But several people in the comments were asking for a how-to video, and here it is. First of all, before we get too deep in it, I wanted to give a shout out to the Boston Invasion. You can see my shirt here. I don't know if you can see with the 2020, what it symbolizes, how we feel about 2020. But I thought this shirt was hilarious. Thanks to Panda Man, Archie, appreciate you, brother, for putting things together. You did a great job from what I saw. I wasn't there in the morning time, and I didn't ride overnight. I was only there for a couple of hours, and I was able to ride with quite a few people. I had a good time with a lot of the people that I saw there. What's up, Tariq? I met quite a few people. Saw David there. David Jansen, good to see you too, brother. There's a lot of people there, and I wish I had gotten to ride with a lot more, but it was fun. At any rate, without further ado, lights, LED strips on the V11. I'm gonna use the cell phone and give you a close-up look at how I did some of these things. But what I did was I took a LED light strip that comes with a USB plug, and that USB is here. And all I did was take out the back plate from the V11 and plug it in to the V11 back here, and then that gives me the ability to use the V11 power source to run the lights on the wheel. And then I just put the rubber plug here and leave it sitting. And that way I don't have to worry about it flopping around. It did a pretty good job of just staying in this little area. If it does, I mean, I could put a piece of tape or something on it, but you can't quite put it in because obviously the plug, USB plug, is in the port, so you can't close it back. Here is the controller and all of the wires. Now, if you look here, you can see, if you look closely, not only did I put the lights through it, but I also taped it. I glued the lights to the wheel, and then I put some tape on it to reinforce it until the glue was completely dry. So you can see the lights here. They start running through here. And what I did was I started on this side here, and again, I'll give you a close-up after, but I'll probably throw it up on the screen next to it. But I started on this side here, and I went right along down alongside the area where the kickstand comes up, because even when the kickstand comes up and closes, it does not pinch the lights. So you can put the lights really close right there, and then I was able to run the lights all the way underneath. And I ran them under the pedal hanger and under the ports where you twist to put the air in when you take the caps off. So it goes under the air caps. Now, what I did was left it just loose enough at that area so that when I'm ready to twist the caps, I can slide it to the side. I also put a piece of tape underneath that, so in case that bumps the ground, it'll scratch the tape first, then the lights. So that part of the lights is covered. Then it goes all the way around. It comes around up the up the side of the wheel, and then it goes right behind the front headlight, and then it loops back down around the other side, and it does the same thing. It goes under the pedal hanger and comes all the way back out the other side, and it ends right here just before it goes into, again, where the kickstand is. So that gives me lights all the way under and all the way around up to the front and all the way around to the back. That is controlled by the controller here. And that gives me the ability to hit the, I can hit the power and power these lights, and I can change it the different colors. It has green, blue, red, yellow, various colors. And then you can change the pulsating or spinning, and you can do that on the other side. So these are the things that you can do with the lights, but whatever lights you get, that'll give you the ability to do that. Now I can control them from here. These lights also have an app, the Govee app, so I could use that app to connect to the lights And then I could do it on my phone if I wanted to, but I like having the buttons right here if I just want to hit them, because sometimes you don't want to fumble with your phone. You can just hit the buttons. I like having the choice and being able to do both. Like I said, various lights give you various options, so it's really up to you. Again, I will give you a link to the lights that I used for this project. Does not mean you have to use those. Any of them will work. Just make sure they say waterproof, because obviously you are outside with the wheel. Not that I'm going to ride in the rain, because I really don't ride in the rain, barely ever, but I did get them waterproof just in case I am out and about and, you know, I do get the wheel wet or I do get caught in the rain. So that's what I did. As a quick side note, I also put on, you can see the power pads or lean pads. I will put a link in the description down below. The EUC power pads, right on Facebook. You can connect with them and they'll send you, he sends them out of Germany. Nice guy. Those of you who have them, you know that they're soft. I do wish that you can get them at a wider gap or a smaller gap. Now I wish I got them at a smaller gap because I have to lean further out to hit the front to get the acceleration. And when I lean with both legs out to this point, I start getting a wobble because I'm so far ahead of the wheel. So I couldn't put it back any further than this. I probably could have inched a little bit more back, but not really far enough back to get what I want out of it. So it's also getting used to it also. But I do have some other pads that I'm going to try out after these. But right now, I'm liking the softness of them. I love how they feel against your leg. And I love that they don't hurt. But, you know, again, I chose the ones with the wider opening. If I had to do it again, I would choose the ones with a slimmer opening. I just wasn't sure. So these are the ones that I got. So that's it. That's it for the light kit. If you have any questions, go ahead and feel free to put them in the comment section down below. As always, I'll get back to you. You guys know I always do. That's it, people. If you like what you see, you like what you hear, you like the energy and enthusiasm, please go ahead and hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. If you want to come back and be notified to come back, hit that notification bell. All right? I appreciate you guys. And until next time, people, please be safe out there. Please gear up. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.